Welcome to MBBS Counsel. We provide MBBS admission counseling guidance for future doctors. In this video, I am going to discuss about the MBBS admission counseling process 2019 in detail. It will provide everything you need to know about counseling. Towards the end of this video, you would get idea on types of college, number of seats, quotas, seats under each quota, fee structure, and types of counseling, etc. If you think this video helped you to understand the counseling process better, I request you to share this video to everyone you know who will be participating in 2019 MBBS admission counseling. We will be publishing videos to provide guidance during MBBS counseling. If you have not subscribed to this YouTube channel, subscribe to this channel now to get notifications on latest updates on counseling. There are three types of medical colleges in India. The first one is Government Medical College. There are 234 Government Medical Colleges with close to 32,500 MBBS seats. The second type is Deemed Universities. There are 40 Deemed Universities with 6,300 MBBS seats. The third type is Self-Financing Medical College or Private Medical College, which are 168 in number. The private colleges have total of 23,200 MBBS seats. For All India Institute of Medical Science and JIPMER, there is a separate entrance exam. So, those seats are not included here. Before moving on to the counseling process, let us first discuss the tuition fees range for these three types of medical colleges. For Government Medical College, the tuition fees ranges from Rs. 10,000 per year to Rs. 1 lakh per year. Most of the government colleges are run by the state government where it resides. So, the tuition fees varies from state to state. For example, Tamilnadu fees is Rs. 13,600 per year. Whereas, for Maharashtra, it is Rs. 76,000 per year. When it comes to deemed universities, it has management quota as well as NRI quota. The management quota fees ranges between Rs. 9 lakhs per year to Rs. 25 lakhs per year. SDU Medical College Kolar has the lowest fees of 9 lakhs per year. DY Patil Mumbai has the highest fee of Rs. 25 lakhs per year. NRI quota fees ranges between $30,000 per year and $60,000 per year. For self-financing colleges, there are three quotas: state government quota, management quota, and NRI quota. The tuition fees for state government quota is subsidized by the state government. So, the tuition fees varies between Rs. 4 lakhs per year to Rs. 6 lakhs per year depending on the state where the medical college is located. For management quota, fees ranges between Rs. 10 lakhs per year to Rs. 40 lakhs per year. For NRI quota, generally all states have restricted the fees to 2 times that of management quota fees. There are 3 ways you can get MBBS seat. The first type is called as All India Counselling conducted by Medical Counselling Committee. 15% seats in all government colleges in India comes under this counselling. The total number of MBBS seats allotted through All India Counselling is approximately 4,900. If your NEET 2019 All India rank is below 10,000, then you may get a chance to get MBBS seat under All India quota unreserved category. The next type of counselling is called Deemed University Counselling, which is again conducted by Medical Counselling Committee. All MBBS seats in Deemed University, which comes to around 6,300 seats, are filled by this counselling. The third type of counselling is called State Counselling, which is conducted by State Medical Counselling Authority. For private colleges located in Karnataka, seats are allotted by Karnataka Medical Counseling Authority. They fill 85% of the seats in government medical colleges. All private college MBBS seats are allotted by respective state counseling authority. This includes state government quota seats, management quota seats, NRI seats, and minority quota seats. If seats cannot be filled by deemed university counseling or through state counseling, it will be allotted by the respective college itself. Now, let's see who can apply for this MBBS quota seats. For All India quota seats, students from any state of India except Jammu and Kashmir can apply. For deemed university seats, students from any state can apply. When it comes to state quota seats and private college seats, only students belonging to the state can apply. If a student does not belong to the state but studied in the state, they can also apply under the domicile category. But most of the states consider domicile students in general category rather than the reserved category. Let us see the step-by-step process of counselling. All India Counselling is an online process. For government colleges, there are 2 rounds of counselling, and for deemed university, there are 3 rounds of counselling. The first step is to register yourself on the Medical Counselling Committee website. After this, you become eligible for All India Counselling. There are 2 rounds of counselling. In each round, you will be selecting college of your choice. Make sure that you pick all the colleges based on your order of preference. After everyone picks their choice, system allocates seats based on the All India rank to all candidates. If you did not get any college in the first round, you can apply for the second round counselling. Unfilled seats in first round of counselling and any new seats added will be part of the second round counselling. If seats are not filled even after the second round of counselling, then those seats are surrendered to the respective states for further counselling. Let's move on to the deemed university counselling process. There is an extra round of counselling in case of deemed university. This round is called as mop-up round. After this mop-up round, if seats are not filled, then it is handed over to the respective medical college for allotment. The first round of counselling generally starts on 2nd week of June and results are announced online during the last week of June. After this, you need to download the allotment letter from the MCC website and report to the medical college for admission. If you are not satisfied with the seat, you need not go to the college and apply in the second round of counselling, which will be around 2nd week of July. For deemed university counselling, there will be another round of counselling during August before handing over seats to the college. You need to make sure that you visit the college allotted in the second round for admission. If you miss to do that, then you may not get the security deposit refunded. Let's move on to state counselling. Some states like Maharashtra conduct their MBBS admission counselling online, and some states like Tamilnadu conduct them offline. In offline mode, you need to visit the counselling centre, verify your documents, pay the fees and choose the available medical college at that time of counselling. In case of online mode, you fill your choices online, an allotment will be done and results are published online. All state governments conduct counselling for the 85% MBBS seats in government colleges located inside the state. For private colleges, 50% of the seats are allotted to students under state government quota at subsidized fees of rupees 4 lakhs per year to 6 lakhs per year. Let's say if a private college has 100 seats, 50 of those seats come under the state government quota. Remaining 50% of the seats come under management quota, NRA quota or minority quota. In many states, these seats are also filled through the state counselling. Like All India Deemed University Counselling, there are 3 rounds of counselling at the state level also. If seats are not filled even after the third round, it is handed over to the respective private medical college for the allotment. Last year, we have received close to 18,000 queries from parents and students regarding MBBS admission counselling. This video is an effort to reduce the confusions parents and students have during the counselling. If you think this video helped you to understand the counselling process better, don't keep it to yourself. Help other parents like you by sharing this video to everyone you think will be participating in the MBBS admission counselling this year. We are planning to publish videos on counselling process and provide guidance for students and parents. Subscribe to this channel now so that you can get latest notifications during the counselling time. If you like this video, please cheer us by clicking the thumbs up button. Thanks for watching this video.